In this short video, I'm going to show you how to save time, avoid mistakes, and increase your efficiency at the Linux command line. Hello, my name is Jason Cannon, and I'm the author of Linux for Beginners, as well as the founder of the Linux Training Academy. Today, I'd like to share a couple of quick tips on how to get the most out of tab completion. Anytime you're at the Linux command line, you can simply press the tab key to invoke auto-completion. When you press tab, the command you're typing is auto-completed if possible. For example, if I type DA and press the tab key, then the date command is displayed. If I want to execute that command, I simply press enter and then the date is displayed. You may have noticed that in addition to auto-completing the command, a space was appended to the command so that the cursor is in such a position so that any arguments to the command can be quickly added. I'm going to do that again, but this time I'm going to add an argument to the command. So I'll type DA tab. Now I'm in the position to add any arguments to the command that I want, so I'm going to use +%F, which displays the date in a nice format. In order for tab completion to fully auto-complete a command, it needs to be given enough of the command to be unique. For example, if I type D and press tab, no commands are auto-completed. You'll probably hear a beep or your terminal might flash. If this happens, you can press tab again to show you your available options. So let me do that now. I'll hit tab again. Now I can see all the commands that I can run which start with D. I'm going to add an M to my command and press tab again. This time the command is auto-completed since it's the only command that begins with DM. You'll notice that there's a space after the command now, and I can add any arguments if I want to. By the way, this DMESG or DMessage command displays messages from the Linux kernel. I'll execute it now by hitting enter. Let's say I want to type the command hostname_ctl. One way to do that is to let tab completion help me along the way. For example, I can type ho tab, which expands to host, and now I can add an n and press tab again. Now it's expanded to hostname. I can finish out the command by typing c, pressing tab, and then hitting enter. Tab completion not only works for commands, it works for command arguments too. I'm going to list the files in this directory by running ls. Here you can see that there are three files. If I want to display the contents of a file, I can use the cat command. So let's look at file1.txt. I'm going to type cat space f tab. Now I can type 1 tab enter to complete the command. If I wasn't sure of my choices, I can just hit tab twice. So I can type cat space f tab. That gets me most of the way there. And by pressing tab twice, it shows the remaining choices. So I press tab, tab. It says I can type file1 or file2.txt. So I'll type 2, press tab for the completion, and hit enter. I'll display the contents of the file with a really long name by simply typing cat space t, pressing tab, and hitting enter. If you found this quick tip helpful, then click the link on this video to download Learn Linux in 5 Days for free. It's packed with dozens of Linux tips designed to help you learn Linux the right way. It's also a great refresher for experienced Linux users too. Again, click the link on this video to download your free copy today. Thanks.